I'm really excited to kick off a brand new video series, which I'm going to be calling the Piano Forum series. Now, the reason I'm going to be starting this series is because all my life I've been around pianos. The household has had at least one piano, and for many years it had far more than only one. At one point we had, I think, 17 pianos at one point. And over the years, obviously I've been playing the piano for many years, and my mom's been teaching for a long time. And once we started getting more pianos as a hobby, my dad also decided to, learn how to fix them and work on them, and I decided to help him out with that as well. And the reason we're doing this video series is because it's very expensive to hire someone else to do work on the piano, regulate it, tune it, fix any issues. And if you have 17 pianos, just multiply that cost by 17, and then it becomes incredibly expensive. So we decided to save lots and lots of money and do our own work on our pianos, and it went very well. So we decided to share our knowledge with you in the Piano Forum series. Now, the reason it's called the Piano Forum series is because you can treat this video as if it's a forum. And if you have any questions about the content that we talked about in the video, just leave a comment down below, and I will do my very best to answer your questions and reply to all of your comments. So let's get started with the first video about basic care of your piano. Many times when I'm out looking at pianos, I will often find that they simply haven't had the proper care, and it's really amazing to find an older piano that has had the proper care, and this piano here is a perfect example of that. When you look on the inside, you'll see that there's no dust anywhere, not anything substantial, maybe just a little tiny bit here and there, but nothing major at all. The tuning pins look brand new, the strings look brand new, the bass strings especially, when you look at them, they're coppery and shiny, they don't have that old, the brown kind of piano look. Even though this piano is 23 years old, it still looks like it's brand new, sounds like it's brand new, and for the most part, plays like it's brand new. It's amazing. All right, here is the inside of the piano again, and here you can see the strings. As I move this flashlight down, you can see just how shiny the strings are. You can see that beam of reflection, and clearly the strings are very clean if they're all doing this very consistently. They're beautiful, silvery, shiny, wonderful, and as a result, they sound very, very nice. Piano's very clean. All right, so by this point, you're probably wondering, why is everything in this piano so clean? Why is the harp so clean? Why are the tuning pins still shiny? And why are the strings still as beautiful as they are? And the answer for this is because the lid on this piano has been closed almost all of its life. And in fact, not only has the lid been closed, but there has been a nice cover over the piano as well. Now, since we've got the piano, I have had the lid closed all the time on the piano, except for when I'm practicing or for when guests come over. And closing the lid all the way, closing the lid down, folding it over, and also even closing the foldware if you want to, is a great way of preserving the piano because it keeps all the dust out. And of course, everyone loves the look of a grand piano with the lid open of any size, concert grand or even a smaller one. It just looks cool. So I can definitely understand why people would just want to leave the lid open all the time. But that gathers dust. Dust collects on the bass strings, make them age faster. It gathers on the soundboard. Doesn't look very good. So closing the lid keeps the dust out and makes the piano look better and sound better for a longer period of time. By this point, I know what you're thinking. Hey, my piano's already dirty. It's already got some dust on it. So what can I do? And the answer to this is you can clean it. There are some specialty tools out there, like these, which are designed for cleaning pianos, and these are soundboard cleaners. And so I'm not actually going to use them on mine because you have to be careful of these. While they do have some soft felt up here, they are made of metal and they can scratch the soundboard. But what you're supposed to do with these is you're supposed to put them like underneath the strings and then reach them forwards and then pull all the dust back out to you where then you can take it out with like a vacuum cleaner or a wet rag or something like that. And there's three different sizes. There's like the really long one here, there is a little small one, and then there's an even little baby one here. And so these are three different sizes that you can use all across the soundboard and clean it and get all that ugly dust off of there. Here's something else that I got in the mail today, and I'm excited to give this a little bit of use. This is a feather duster, and this is used for getting all those easy to reach areas, such as perhaps the top of the harp, or even the outside of the piano, or something like that. It's very, very soft, it's not going to damage or scratch anything, and it's very, very, obviously, very easy to use, and it's used for getting all those big, wide easy to get air.
Another thing that a feather duster is great for is cleaning off the lid of your pianos. Now, different pianos will have different styles of finishes, but this one has the old-style hand-rubbed lacquer finish. And it has these lines on the side of the piano where the piano was rubbed. And so you will want to go along with these lines like so. On Steinways, these lines will run this way. The grain and the finish will go lengthwise down the piano. Almost every other piano manufacturer does it horizontally across the piano. So you just take it, you just scrape all, not really scrape all the dust off, but you just wipe all the dust off like so. It's very easy. And it makes your piano look really nice. And of course, on this middle section here, you can just take the dust and get it off. And there's some down here as well. This happens a lot with feather dusters, little parts come off. Then you can just go down the piano, get all that dust off. That easy. Hopefully you have enjoyed this first episode in our brand new series, the Piano Forum series. Like I said at the beginning of the video, if you have any questions or comments, make sure to leave them down in the comment section below, and make sure to subscribe and stay tuned for a whole bunch of other exciting videos in this series. We're going to be talking about piano tuning, we're going to be talking about all kinds of work that you yourself can do to your piano, and we're going to be showing you just how simple it is. So make sure to stay tuned for that.